and you're now with the Forerunner Chronicles. All right, everybody, so the debate that could easily be crowned the biggest debate amongst all Christians throughout the world is this one question. Is it possible for a Christian to be perfect? Now, before you jump through your cell phone screen and try to strangle me with doctrine that has been conceived in your mind, which I'm sure you have great intentions and just the sincerest desires to correct me on this point so that we can move on to the next video, I want to press the pause button for a second and give you the opportunity to think about what you're thinking about. Because for us to gain an accurate answer on this topic as Christians, those who are seeking to follow Christ, we can't go to our pastors, our priests, and definitely not our popes for the answer. As individuals that are seeking to be followers of Christ, we must see what Jesus Christ himself has to say concerning this issue. And whatever Jesus has to say, it must be absolute truth. Because in the book of John chapter 14 and verse 6, Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me." It is only when we place our full dependence in the instruction concerning the will of the Father as revealed to us through Jesus Christ that we can know that we are walking in the pathway of truth. So once again, what does Jesus Christ himself have to say to those who are seeking to be Christians concerning this topic? Is it possible for a Christian to be perfect? Well, the Bible answers this question clearly and definitively right in the book of Matthew chapter 5 and verse 48, where Jesus Christ himself stated, "Be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father, which is in heaven, is perfect." Now that's a clear, concise, distinct statement that is made by the mouth of Jesus Christ himself. Be ye therefore perfect. And yet, although this statement has been on the biblical record for generations, there are still billions of Christians throughout this world that are debating as to whether or not this is possible. Now, either Jesus is a liar, and he's not, or we have a very perverted understanding of what perfection is and how we are to obtain to this perfection. You see, in the book of Matthew chapter 5 and verse 48, when the Bible is calling us to perfection, that word perfection there in the original language means to be complete or to be fully matured. Ladies and gentlemen, that's exactly why Jesus communicated to us the gifts of the Spirit according to the book of Ephesians chapter 4 and verse 13, where the Bible says, "Till we all come into the unity of the faith and to the knowledge of the Son of God, unto a perfect man, unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ." It is God's desire that we become perfect men in Jesus Christ that grow or mature into the full measure and stature of our elder brother, our great high priest and our Savior, Jesus Christ the righteous. Before the anomaly of sin intruded into God's creation, man was created in a state of perfection. And through the plan of redemption, it is God's design to restore man into that perfect state. So the question is on the table, how do we obtain to that perfection? Here's the answer. You work as hard as you can for 24 hours, 7 days a week, 30 to 31 days a month, 365 days a year in all your might, and you will be perfect. Of course, I'm not telling you something that I believe. I'm being sarcastic because once again, I know you're sitting behind your computer screen or your cell phone screen screaming, saying this man is a legalist. My friends, we're not preaching the doctrine of works. We are preaching what Jesus Christ declared in Matthew chapter 5 and verse 48. He said, "Be ye therefore perfect." So if Christ is calling you to be perfect, like your heavenly Father is perfect, then you need to ask Jesus the question, how do I obtain to that perfection? And the answer that Christ will give you is found once again in his holy word. In the book of Jude, verse 24, the scripture says, "Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy." Notice that he is the one that is capable of keeping you from falling so that he can present you faultless before the throne of God. If Jesus has the ability to present you faultless before the throne of glory, that means Jesus possesses the power, possesses the ability to make you perfect, to make you complete, to groom you so that you can mature into the full measure and stature of one that reflects the character of the one who died on the cross so that you could be saved from all of your sin. My friends, the power lays in the hands of Jesus. Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling. You know, this point is illustrated in a fashion that I could never do in my wildest imagination in the book of Genesis chapter 17, beginning at verse 1, where the Bible says, "Now when Abram was 99 years old, the Lord appeared to Abram in a dream and said, 'I am the Almighty God. Walk before me and be thou perfect.'" There it is once again. You can see that God calling us to perfection is not exclusive in the New Testament. It's found right back there in the book of Genesis, and he spoke to the father of the faithful, Abram. He said to Abram, "I am the Almighty God. Walk before me and be thou perfect." Now, I need you to take some time to consider what's going on here, because God could have come to Abram in the dream and presented himself as Jehovah or the I Am, but he came and presented himself to Abram as the Almighty God. This is significant. I want you to think about this. If Mark Zuckerberg called you on the phone, and you know that you've been sitting at home, you lack skills, you lack talent, you lack physical ability, and you lack finances. But Mark Zuckerberg calls you on the phone and says, "Hey, listen, I've been checking out your social media page. I like your face. I want you to come to my office tomorrow because I want you to be successful with me." Hold on a second. If Mark Zuckerberg called you on the phone, the million-dollar Facebook boy Mark Zuckerberg called you on the phone and invited you to his office and said, "I want you to come to my office because I want you to be successful," how would you feel? Even though you know you lacked talent, physical ability, finances, etc., would you feel hope that you were going to be successful? Why? Because Mark Zuckerberg called you on the phone and now all of a sudden you have talent, all of a sudden you have an education, you have a PhD all of a sudden, and now all of a sudden your bank account is filled with money? No, that's not the reason why you have hope in your heart that exists there because Mark Zuckerberg called you on the phone. The reason that you have hope of success in your heart right now is because you know the one that called you on the phone is extremely successful and he possesses all that is necessary to make you successful as well. And that is why when God presents himself to Abram and he knows he's getting ready to call him to perfection, he presents himself to Abram as the Almighty God. So as this high calling is set before the face of Abram, he has hope that he can obtain to it because the one that calls him possesses all might to bestow upon him so that he can obtain to this holy calling of being perfect. It's the same thing for you and for myself. Jesus, the righteous, can make you righteous. Jesus, the perfect one, can make you perfect. Because if Christ is dwelling in you, the hope of glory, if he calls you to reveal glory, if you submit to him, all you can do is reveal glory. Are you getting the point right now? Furthermore, notice where God tells Abram to walk. He didn't say, "Abram, I'm the Almighty God. Walk beside me and be thou perfect." I mean, think about this. If you have a little child and they're just learning how to walk, do you say, "Okay, baby of 5 months old, okay, 8 month baby, walk beside me, walk"? No, I mean, nobody does that. Who does that? Nobody does that. If you have a baby, you set the baby in front of you so that you can see the baby. And as the baby is trying to walk, you are in a position to assist the baby to keep the baby from falling. Do you see what's going on right now? The Bible says in the book of Isaiah chapter 41 and verse 10 that God says to us, "Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. Yea, I will strengthen thee. Yea, I will help thee. Yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand," with the right hand of my righteousness. You see, when God is calling us to walk before him, to exhibit the perfection of his righteousness, he is literally inviting us to take a position in which he can support us with his own perfect, infallible, righteous character, my friends. Because the scripture tells us in Philippians chapter 2 and verse 13, "For it is God that worketh in you, both to will and to do of his good pleasure." It's God working in you, not you working for God, but God working in you to perform the will that he wants to see revealed in you. And that is perfection, completeness, to be like Jesus. But the reason why many of us don't even attempt to do that which God has called us to do is because he didn't say walk beside him or walk behind him. He said walk before him. Get the point here. If you're walking side by side with someone, you can see them in their peripheral. If you're walking behind them, you can definitely see them right before you. But if you're walking in front of someone, you cannot see what's going on behind you. You can only see what is in front of you. And that's why the scripture says in the book of 2 Corinthians 5 and verse 7, "For we walk by faith, not by sight." God has given you enough assurance in your Christian walk already that the great work he's begun in you, he can complete it. Did God give you victory over drug addiction? Did God give you victory over a bad temper? Did God give you victory over alcohol, over fornication, over worldly music? Then why can't God finish the work in you and complete you in the beauty of his righteousness? He's given you enough faith. He's given you enough for you to trust him, just like a child that knows their parent loves them and desires the best for them and is willing to place themselves in a position of submission, in a position, my friends, of total dependence. Are you willing to walk before him so he can make you perfect? And it's so interesting. God didn't call Abram when he was 30 years old, 40 years old, 50 years old. God called Abram when he was 99 years old and told him to conduct himself like an infant. You know, it's interesting. Many of you out there, you're 50, 60, 70, some of you 80 years old. And you think you're still around here because you've got good genetics. You're not around because you have good genetics. You're around because you have a good God. And he's still keeping you around because he wants you to learn how to walk before him and be perfect so that he can present you faultless before the presence of his glory. One last thought. The wording in the book of Matthew chapter 5 and verse 48, it's similar to the wording that you find in the creation account in the book of Genesis chapter 1. He said, "Be therefore perfect," the same way that he says in Genesis chapter 1, "Let there be light." That is creative language coming from the very mouth of the Creator himself. Therefore, the very word has power in it to make you what it is calling you to be. God is calling you with his own creative power to be perfect. And the same way that light came into existence when God said, "Let there be light," and trees came into existence when God said, "Let there be trees. Let the firmament be divided," and all of the various other things that are contained within the creation account, as God spoke those things into existence, and they were. If you do not resist the creative power of the word of God from being performed in your life and place your total dependence in the word of God, you too, my friend, can be perfect. So Jesus calls you, "Be therefore perfect." Will you let it be? That's your decision. As always, this is the Forerunner, and whether you like it or not, the truth is the truth.